This is an excerpt from Will Richardson's Freedom to Learn. Imagine for a moment that you're back in the midst of your adolescence and you're standing in the entranceway of the biggest library you've ever seen. Just as you step in to start taking a look around, you're stopped by a middle-aged man in a sport coat and tie who asks you how old you are. 13, you say quietly, since you are in a library after all. I see, the man says as he walks behind a large oak desk, opens a drawer, and starts to dig around in it. Just one second. Ah, here we go. He hands you a little black remote-like box and asks you for your name, which he notes on a clipboard. What is this, you ask? Why, it's your access key, of course. Access key? You frown as you turn it over in your hand. What's an access key? Just take the elevator up to the 57th floor, turn right, and follow the signs to the 8th grade section, he says. This key will let you in, and I think there's 4 or 5 shelves full of materials up there now. 4 or 5 shelves? But what about all this other stuff, you ask, as you sweep your arm across the vastness of the space? Mean I can't look at any of it? You mean I can't look at any of it? Oh no, he says. You can't just roam around in here. We've already got everything you need to know picked out, and that's all that key will open. Now run along. How do you think your 13-year-old self would feel at that moment? If you're like me, my guess is not really great. And yet, this is pretty much what we do to our connected kids every single day when they arrive in our classrooms. We tell them to put their amazing huge online libraries away and focus only on the comparatively tiny slice of content and skills that we've pre-selected for them.